So today we are going to discuss active passive voice. I am going to share rules with you of active passive voice, and you will be doing all these rules in your fair notebook. You'll be writing. I'm going to start from the very beginning, slowly and gradually. I will be reaching at 9th class level, okay? Because your paper, whether it is asked in subjective form or whether it is asked in MCQ form, it should be very much clear rules. If rules are very much clear, so any type of questions are asked, subjective or MCQs, you should be proficient in that. And it, yes. Yes. No, not PT1, not this one. We have started PT2. So this grammar, you do it very carefully. These rules you have to do in your fair notebook. And you complete your notebook side by side, because now offline has started and your notebook collection will also be done offline. So very soon after this completion, I'm going to collect and I will be checking side by side. Okay, so start writing these rules, active passive voice. Active and passive. Write down neatly.
Morning, ma'am.
Yes, good morning. Only 5 online students are there. My whole class is full with offline students. And now it will be very easy for you to understand me, and it will be very much easy for me to understand you now. Because during online classes, you people were enjoying. Whenever I was asking you question, you were keeping your mobiles and you can say laptops and PCs, cameras off. But now you can't keep your face off. I can see you. I can see all your activities, what you are doing in class. So it's better that you become a good student. You are grown up. You are in 9th class. You are sensible. In the beginning, I have told you each and everything, whatever I'm teaching you, you are supposed to do in your fair notebook. So I should speak in Punjabi now. Tell me. So write down first rule. So these are the rules of indefinite tense. Present definite first form, or you can say first form, or S or ES is used. And it will be changed into SMR plus third form plus Y. Past indefinite second form, it will be used as a passive, was, were, plus third form plus Y. Future indefinite will, shall, plus verb first form, it will be changed into will be or shall be, verb third form plus by. So these are the rules of doing present, past and future indefinite tense in active passive voice. Okay, after writing this, राइट डाउन रूल नंबर फोर. Those who are not serious in my class and creating a nuisance, they will not be allowed to sit during offline class. So don't give me a chance to scold you. Do your work nicely and be a good student. So when present continuous tense is given, like is, am, are, verb first form plus ing is given, and you are supposed to change active to passive. So what you will be doing is am, are, plus being, plus third form plus by, and was, were, plus verb first form is given. Then you will be using was, were, plus being. See, bachche, there is a huge difference between being and been. So don't get confused between these two things. Being is a different thing and been is a different thing. In place of ing, we use being. So many students commit that mistake, but you don't commit. Keep this point in your mind. With for ing, we are supposed to use being, b-e-i-n-g, okay, then third form plus by. If you will be doing like this, tenses will also be revised side by side. What is the rule of future continuous tense? Can anybody tell me? In future continuous, what do we use? Yes, very good. Your name is Prane. Will be or shall be plus verb first form plus ing. When this is given in passive, there is no change. Why so? Can anybody tell me why it is no change? Can anybody tell me why it is not changed, will be and shall be? Because already it is given in be. So in passive we are writing be, but here it is already given, so there will be no change. Clear? So I have told you three rules of present indefinite, three rules of continuous. Now I'm going to share with you perfect rules. Okay? Written these. In present perfect tense, if you have been given has, have plus third form, it will be changed into has, have, been. Now been will come. Where, when we have ing, then we will be using being. But when we have has and have, and we are going to change active into passive, so with has and have, we will be using been. So don't get confused between being and been. And when we have been given past perfect tense had plus third form, it should be changed into had been plus verb third form plus by. Clear? So this was rule number 8. Clear? Now listen carefully. When we have been given future perfect tense, will have third form or shall have third form. So when we are going to use change this, so will have or shall have will be written according to subject. With that we will be adding been. Okay, so been will be added rest of verb third form plus by. Clear? If you have any problem, you can ask me. There is no need to discuss with each other. Okay? Keep silence. Now return 6th, 7th, 8th rule. Last one, do you have any problem? When any model is given, with model we always use verb first form. So with model, verb first form is given in active voice, and when you are supposed to change active into passive, then we will be using model plus be plus third form. Now models can be may, might, can, can, could, will, shall, should, must. When these models are given, with every model, verb first form will be given in active voice. So when models are given with verb first form and you have to change active to passive, what you will be doing? We'll be adding may, be, might, be, can, be, could, be, will, be, shall, be, should, be, must, be. With all that we will be using third form plus by. She will give a gift. A gift will be given by her. Renuka is raising her hand. Yes, Renuka, what is your doubt?
I mean, models when we are changing it to passive voice. Ma'am, it will be we will be using like maybe plus VC and by also.
Yes. That's why I've written like this, because you people get confused. When you do active to passive, you change may into might, will into would, can into could. You follow the rules of narrations and you become confused. That's why I have written like this, so that you should not get confused. All of the list is given to you. Okay. But here, when you are changing active into passive, so you will be using be with that. Will, shall, may, might, all these models will remain same. All these models will remain same when you will be changing active to passive, but you have to add be only. Okay, are you feeling any change between you? Because earlier you were attending your lectures online, it was easy for you to understand grasp, or it is easy for you to understand during offline?
Online.
Tell me.
Online.
So that's good. So, bachche, write down all these rules very, very carefully. Write down all these rules very, very carefully. Afterwards, I'm going to give you some of the sentences. See, you solve these sentences. Okay, and whenever these kind of active passive voice are asked in your paper, you solve its answer on your own, then find out that your answer is given in MCQ or not. So your rule should be clear, answer should be very much clear in your mind, you should be very much sure about them, then it will be easy for you to do MCQ. Otherwise, if you go through every option and you will make a guess, no, this option is right, that option is right, it will be worked on your guesswork, and in this way you are not going to score good marks. Clear? So write down sentences if you have written this. Shall I rub it?
Yeah.
Revise all these rules. Yes. रख देना ओके स्टार्ट राइटिंग यू डू दी सेंटेंसेस ऑन योर notebooks. Afterwards, we'll do practice from your grammar book. Okay. And after writing all these rules, make one table also. And in this table, write down I changes into me. He changes into him. She changes into you. Changes into you. Yes. We changes into us. They changes into and it changes into it. Okay, so you make this table also. Then I'm going to give you some of the sentences. Yes. No. Inderjit ma'am.
Ma'am, she was talking about
Inderjit ma'am, she was teaching you story writing, and she told that in every section the English is. I don't know how can she say like this. Because ninth class we have taught and we have checked. She teaches 10th. She might be checking another section. I don't know. So you have written this? Ninth class? What happened? Keep silence. So all these rules are written by you? You have written all these rules? Okay. Now suppose you have been given imperative sentences. In active voice, you have been given any imperative sentence. What are imperative sentences? Order, request, advice, suggestion, command. So when such kind of sentences are given, and you have to change active to passive, so what will be doing? When any imperative sentence is given, so what is the rule? You here you'll be adding like you are ordered to plus, you are ordered to plus verb first form plus object, or you are requested to verb first form plus object. So this is the way to do active into passive. This is the way to change active to passive. Your order to, for example, I take one example. Open the books. Open the books. So how will you change active to passive? You are ordered. You are ordered. You'll be adding to. We'll be adding two. Yes. You are ordered to, then you are supposed to use first form. You are ordered to open the books. You are ordered to open the books. Clear?
Yes.
Written? Some students, now I'm noticing their names. They are not serious in offline class. It's better that I should give their names in office, and they will not be given permission to come inside the school. They'll be attending their classes online only. I'm keeping their names in my mind. Let me see for my 1 or 2, 3 days more. Then I will take this decision. Because they are creating a lots of problems. They are continuously talking in my class without any purpose, and they don't deserve to be sit among offline students. If we have option, why not to go for that? Why we are having such a crowd of these students, those who are not serious at all? You are coming to school only for enjoyment, to create fuss. Even some girls are also not serious of this class. If I take their names, that they will start crying in front of me. Now, next rule that you write down. Active voice, if subject plus verb plus any preposition is given, or adverbial participle is given, plus object is given. Yes, adverbial participle is given. So how will you change? The rule of changing is, subject will be there, and this subject will be new subject. Okay, then helping verb will be there, then third form plus preposition, or you can say adverbial participle. Plus by object, new one. That will be there. I just take one example. It means if simple verb you are taking and along with that verb any preposition is given, so you will not make that preposition different. You will keep it together. Verb with preposition, verb with preposition. Clear? For example, you should act upon my advice. You should act upon my advice. So what will be that? My, tell me. This will be a new subject. My advice here is an object. But this object will become now your subject. After that, helping verb. My advice, what is helping verb? Should. With helping verb, you will be using third form. Okay, so helping verb plus my advice should be acted. So what is preposition used here? Upon. Acted upon by you. So by you can put in bracket. If you want, you can write down. My advice should be acted upon.
I only
Subject and object is given, and when you change active to passive, the subject will become object and object will become subject. Only this much you have to keep in your mind. Subject will become object and object will become subject. So these are the rules that you have to write down. After writing all these rules, I will be giving you one of the homework. The homework is that here prepositions are given along with that. Sorry, I can't. Another example, I am taking a bus ran over a cyclist. So what is object here? A cyclist. So here it will become subject. A cyclist ran is the second form. So you'll be using was. A cyclist was. Third form, run over. With verb, you'll be using that preposition. A cyclist was run over by a bus. Only this much is in your syllabus of active passive voice. After writing all these rules in your rough, in your fair notebook, you will be doing practice of exercise from your grammar book. The more you practice, the more you'll be learning. Okay, so it's better that you do practice. Dhiren and Renuka, they both are raising their hands. Yes, Dhiren, your doubt.
Ma'am, can we write an imperative sentence as let the book be opened by you?
Yes, this is also a right way. Yes, Renuka.
Okay, ma'am.
Ma'am, please move the camera to the right side.
Aditya is saying it's Renuka's birthday. Okay, Renuka, happy birthday to you. Renuka, I wish you a very, very happy birthday. Renuka is saying it was yesterday. Okay, belated happy birthday. Okay, students, now time is running out. You do all these active passive in your fair notebook after doing formal letter writing. And listen, tomorrow we will be starting chapter from Beehive. So you all should have books with you, Beehive. Packing chapter we will be starting tomorrow. So you all should have Beehive books with you to do chapter packing tomorrow. Okay, thank you and have a nice day.